going to show you as a teacher how to modify the Google Forms that you're creating for your students to take to be able to allow them to edit their responses. And you might want to do this because possibly they may not be able to finish within a class period, or you may be concerned that students are not able to properly submit, like it stops on them or some other reason that they're not able to submit at that time, or they just need to get back and edit them. So what you're going to want to do is use the Google Form as usual and create your form. Next, you're going to navigate up to the settings wheel up here to the top right. And I'm under general right now. And for sure, you want to limit to one response. This is going to allow them to access what their previous responses are. And you also need to have edit after response. For sure, those two, because we work in Wayland, restricting it to Wayland school users, I have that checked. That is not necessary, but that's probably a good idea. So now I'm going to click on Save, and I'm going to show you what happens. So I'm going to go ahead and take this as a user, and I'm just going to submit some answers here. And I'm going to tap on Submit. You will notice once I submit, it allows me to edit my response here. Let's just say I'm a student, I'm done, I finished taking it. So you're going to see, as a teacher, when I'm looking at the results here on a spreadsheet, I do see the student's answers. Let's just go back and let's say the student either didn't have a chance to finish, or if they realize you allow them to edit their answers. So I'm going to go back, and because I'm logged into this account, you'll notice normally people get you've already responded. So if you're logged into that account, like my regular Google account, it's going to now allow me to edit my response right from there. Now if I go back in here, you'll see it does put my responses that I had, and then I'm going to add the word modified here, and I'm going to tap submit again, and it does say sharing this URL allows others to edit your response. I can open a blank form, so if I wanted to start over, I could do that as well. But I'm going to go ahead and edit my submission, tap on submit, and then let's go back to this. Notice you just see it did change, and what I like to know as well is as a teacher, it does have a little comment right there that responder updated this value. So you are going to see the updated answer in there. So hopefully this Take 2 for Tech has allowed you to see how you can possibly modify your Google Form to allow students to edit their answers.